Hello everyone, welcome to the Makri Virtual. Hope you are doing good. Today I am going to continue with your module, that is a procedural programming module. In today's class I will be starting your next chapter, that is chapter number 12, file input output. Here this is mistakenly written as a chapter number 11, but it is chapter number 12. So this is chapter number 11 last class. But now in the today's class I'm going to start with the chapter number 12, that is file input output. But before that, as for the previous classes, let's take a quick review what we have covered in the last class. In the last class we have covered with the console input output. Yeah, one more thing, I want to display your you want the practical approach, like Turbo C++, your Turbo C. So this is the Turbo C, this is a window. When I click on this window, this will be activated, and whenever this will be activated, this is processing, and then a new page will be opened. This is the new page for the C++ program or the C program. If I want to write any program, simply click on this program and I can write the code over here, anything. So this is the way, these are the keys that is available. Alt plus F9 is to compile, F3 is to open, F2 is to save, F1 is to help. Then these are the various commands that is available. Simply we are using the new option, save option, that's all. And one is the quit option. If I click on quit, I can reach on the desktop again. So this is the way the procedural programming, that is the C language, will be used. So let's start with the first of all introduction with the main program. How I write this program in the this one, that is in Turbo C. So first of all, let's take with this program. So in the first line, I'm writing hash include, that is a header file, hash include stdio.h. Right. In the same way, hash include conio.h. Right. Then we are starting with the void main function. Then there is a curly braces. Then there is a variable declaration, for example int a comma b. Then there is a semicolon, then uses a printf, that is printf, or printf. First of all, I have made simple program. The a will be assigned as a 10, b will be assigned as a 20, right? In the next line, using or a new variable will be declared, that is a sum, that is int sum, that is only for calculation. Then uses sum equals to a plus b. Sum equals to a plus b. Again, there is a semicolon. Then printf in double quotes value of sum is now I'm using the sum variable as a int. So here I have to write the percentage d. Then double quotes closed, then there is a variable that is a sum. Now this will be terminated by the semicolon. Now write the getch, there is a curly brace, then there is a semicolon, then this curly brace will be closed. Now if I want to compile it, alt plus F9 is the key. There is a success, that means there is no error. Now if I want to display the output, first of all execute, that is done by control plus F9. The value of sum is 30. When I press enter, this will be printed. So this is the way. Now how C program will be compiled, I'm repeating again. First of all, these are the two header files that is included, that is hash include stdio.h. This is the header file. The full form of this header file is standard input output dot header file. In the same way, in the next line, there is a conio.h, that is common input output. So this is STDIO means standard input output, and the conio means the common input output dot h. Right. Then there is a main function or void main function. Then there is a curly braces. Then these are the variable declaration, that is a and b are declared as a variable that is equals to the 10, that is equals to 20. Then another variable is declared, that is sum, then uses the sum variable and stores the output of a plus b, that is first of all adding the values, that is a plus b, and that will be stored in the sum variable. Then uses the printf for printing the values. I am written value of sum is percentage d. Why percentage d? Because it is in the integer, that's why percentage d. Then there is a variable that displays the output, that is a sum, means sum contains the addition of 10 plus 20, that is 30. Then getch, that means the value will be printed on the screen. This is the way how the value will be printed on the screen. Right. If I do not want this, I can use the double slash. If I use double slash, this means this is a comment, not the code. Now, if I compile this one using Control F9, this is success. No, there is no output. Why? Because getch is not used. Now, if I remove this one, means adding up the getch, when I compile Control F9, then the output will be printed, that is value of sum is 30. Right. So this is the way the code will be written. So now, if you want to write the code in your notebook, in your notepad, then please write it. This is the code for the addition. Now, again, I have to make the code, but now it is user defined. That is, user will take the code. First of all, uses printf, enter the value of a. Right. Then printf, enter the value of b. There is a semicolon, and after this the scanf will be used, that is scanf percentage d. Why we are using percentage d? Because it is defined as an integer. So this is percentage d. Then there is a comma, then there is a ampersand a, that this will be closed, bracket will be closed. In the same way, the output or the input is scanned in the memory, that is scanf percentage d ampersand b. There is a semicolon. Right. Then uses the sum variable to add the values and print the values. Now, if I want to run this program, uses Control F9. This says enter the value of sum. This, you see, this is explained in only one line, that is enter the value of c. But if I want in not in the next line, that want in next line, so I use CLR SCR. Then there is a curly braces and there is a closing. Now this will clear the screen. So enter the value of A. If I have written 10, enter the value of B. The output is 30. Right. In the same way, if I want to again compile it, enter the value of A, that is 55. Enter the value of B, that is 65. Then output will be 120. This is the way the code will be used. So this is the user defined code. The previous one is the predefined, that is, we have predefined the values, that is the value of A and the value of B. This is the user defined, means user can give the values as per their requirement. So this is the way the output will be shown in the C++ or C. So if you want to write the code, you can write the code. This says if you want to save, yeah, I want to save. I want to save by the name, that is, the name is first program dot, or addition dot c, because this is the addition program, that is addition dot c. This will be saved. So now You are able to understand? First of all, tell me you are able to understand. This is the good one, because you need the practical approach. That's why I download this one, and you need the practical approach. Okay, good. So I think this is understandable, right? If you want to write the code which I've written in the Turbo C, I can also again display the Turbo C. If you want, please tell me. If you want to write the code of the addition, you can. I will display the screen again of the C++. Otherwise, I will continue with the session. That is chapter number 12 or chapter number 11. So, do you want the screen again to write the code? Yeah, you can use the Microsoft Visual, but it's my advice to first of all use the Turbo C, because this is the base. If you don't able to use the base, because that is a drag and drop facility, automatically curly braces will get. How I create the exe file? You can create the exe file. If I go into this one, right, this one, this is the Turbo C, right? If I go into this one, all programs, these are the various files that is available in this one, that is Turbo C. There is a Turbo C++, there is a bin folder in this one. These are the various files that is available for this one. These are the various exe files that is available. This is the bin that is available. Yeah, sure, Larry. Yes, Larry, tell me. I am able to hear me. Are you able to hear me? Yes, yeah, sure. Because you are not using the getch at the end of the program. Are you using the getch? Yeah. No. But it's my advice, first of all, download this one, that is Turbo C. That is most important one. Yeah, this Turbo C. Okay, the same. Okay. So you now you can type that getch like this one. This is the main program. So again, you have to write the same code. If first of all, try to write the same code in the Turbo C. And if there is any error, right now. You have a Turbo C right now? So please copy this code only, and you can type the code. Now, if there is any difficulty, immediately ask from me. I've given a time. You can run the code, this code only, which I showed on my screen. So that your concept is clear. If there is any error, Olesam, if you are able to write the code in the Turbo C, you can in the this time only, immediately. Because if you are able to understand this code, this is the basic code, so you are able to understand each and every errors. Yeah, I'm able to hear me. Yeah, the main reason is that you do not use getch. Please use the getch, then your program is never terminate. Your output will be displayed. This is the getch. Okay, thanks a lot. So should I continue with the session? All right. In the last class, we have studied about the chapter number 11. All right, Alessa. In the last class, we have studied about the chapter number 11, chapter number 11, console input output. Right. In this, we have studied what are the various types of input and output that is given, like printf, scanf, and C compiler, how C compiler supports these input and output operations. Right. Then, we have studied about the printf and the scanf statement. These are the two basic statements that is available in any C program. Then we have divided, or the C divides the library functions for input output into two categories. What are the two categories? One is console input output functions, one is file input output function. And in the last class, we have finished with the console input output function. That is the function that is used to take the input from the keyboard and to generate the output on the VDU, that is video display unit. Then next part is file input output, that is a function that is used to perform input output on a floppy disk or the hard disk. That is the today's topic. Then we have studied about the in detail what is the console input output function. This is the figure that shows what is the console input output functions. The console input output is again divided into two parts. What are the two parts? The first part is formatted function, another part is unformatted function. In formatting functions, we have to give the formatting, how we can give the, or how we can change the appearance of the C program, output of the C program that is available in any C programming language. That is how to change the appearance of the program. Then second part is your unformatted functions. That is the next function that is given, and what are the different types of data, what are the different types of inputs, output that is available for the unformatted functions. So first of all, we studied about the formatted function, that is printf and the scanf. Then next we have studied about the in detail what is printf and how printf will be used. This is the example that is given about the printf. These are the various outputs. Then we have discussed about the format specifier, that is percentage %d, percentage %f. The percentage %d is used for the int, the percentage %f is used for the float, and percentage %c is used for the character, percentage %s is used for the string. So these are the basic four format specifier, and there are so many detailed format specifier that is available in any C language programming. Then this says we can provide following optional specifier that is given in the format specification, that is DD, right. Then we have discussed about the format specifier that is available. You can use it by using the percentage %10D, that means it gives the 10 columns to the right hand side and then displays the output with the indentation. This is the example that we have discussed in the last class. This is again the example that is discussed in the last class. And this is again the formatting string, that is how we can use the printf with the string, that is the next part. Then we have discussed about the escape sequences. What are the escape sequences? Suppose if I'm using the slash n, then that is displayed the output in the next line. In the same way, if I'm using the slash t, that is used to display the characters in a tab, that is after some gap. That is known as the escape sequences, and that is used by using the backspace symbols, that is considered as the escape characters. This is the output of the program that is given. Then these are the escape sequences, these are the purpose. There are total 9 number of escape sequences that is available. This is N, that is new line, B, that is backspace, F, that is form field. This is the single quotes, that is a single quote. Then double slash, that is used for backslash. In the same way, the tab, carriage return, alert, and the double quotes. Right. This is the printf statement that is available over here. Then this is the output of the C programming that is available. This is the next program to discuss about the different data types like char, int, float, double or string. Then we will discuss about the sprintf and the scanf. So it works with similar to the printf, but there is a single difference or there is a small difference. The sprintf, you can create the blank in between text by using the gap or by using the tab. That is, you can use the escape sequence character, that is a tab slash T. So there is a blank you can use in this. If you want only single blank, then use the 1D or 1F. That is, with prior to the specifier, you can specify the numbers 1, 2, 3. If you want two columns gap, that is two dots gap, you can use the 2D. If you want three columns gap, you want you write 3D, 4D, 5D. So on. If you want a tab gap, that is at least 0.5 centimeter gap, that is given by the slash T. So sprintf and the scanf, the sprintf is similar to the printf. The main difference is that it prints the output in an array of string, in an array of characters. A simple printf, that is only printf, that prints the output on the screen, while the sprintf prints the output on the array of characters, to an array of characters. This is the example that is given. In the same way as we discuss about the sprintf. Yes, 1D is single gap, means a single dot, that is what we have covered, like this one. If there is a single gap, this is a single gap, that is only 1D, right? Is it clear, Larry? One D means there is a single gap, there is a single column gap. Okay, all right. Then there is a scanf function that is similar to the printf. Means in printf we are going to display the output on the screen. By using scanf we are going to key in the memory, that is feeding in the memory. While scanf and sprintf, the same part, the sprintf is used to display on an array of characters, while the scanf is used to display on the or read the data into an specified format into array of characters. Then we have discussed about the unformatted console input output function. That is, what are the categories of unformatted console input output functions. So these are the various categories of the console input output function, that is unformatted console input output functions. This is the program that we have discussed about this one, and one more function that we have discussed, that is getch, getche. This is getche, getch, getchar, getchar, fgetchar. Then this is the program that we have discussed about how we can use the fchar, fgetchar, putchar, getchar. Then at last we have discussed about two functions, that is gets and the posts. The main use is that puts is similar to the printf, but it can also accept the multi-word string. That is, we can display the multi-word string by using the gaps. But in printf we cannot print the values in the gap. And the gets is also used to display the or store the multi-word string in the memory. Suppose my requirement is that I have to store the variable as a honey sing, or there is a Mary D'Souza, For example, so there is a multi-string, so there is a first name, there is a last name, so that can also be stored in the memory by using the gets. So in simple terms, whenever we use the gets inputs, that is similar to the scanf and the printf, but it is used for the multi-word string. Then we have discussed about the summary, that is what is the summary, what we have discussed in the full chapter. Then we have discussed about the question answers. This is the exercise that I've told you that you have to complete the exercise, at least 5 questions you have to do. But I agree there are so many problems, because until and unless you cannot try the program, you cannot get the errors, and you cannot clarify the errors, you cannot get the questions. So now you get the questions, now it's okay for me that you are trying something. It good, everyone is good. Now, I'm going to start with your next chapter, that is chapter number 12, that is file input output. Here this is wrong written as the chapter number 11, that is by my mistake. So I'm so sorry for this. But it is chapter number 12, that is file input and output. In this there are various topics. First of all, there is a data organization. Then file operations, that means opening, closing, reading, then counting characters, then a file copy program, writing to the file, file opening modes, that is read, write, executes, then the awkward new line, that is the input-output lines in the file, then record input-output, text file, means what are the different files, how we can record them, how we can use the database management, then how we can use the input-output under the Windows. So these are the various topics that is discussed in the or that I will be discussing in this chapter. Maybe in today's class, maybe in tomorrow's class, but I have to finish this chapter latest by tomorrow. So I'm going to start with this one. This says, often it is not enough to just display the data on the screen. Means there is this is not enough that the data will be displayed on the screen. This is because if the data is so large, only a limited amount of it can be stored in the memory. That is, if there is a large amount of data, data that is available, only a limited amount, only a few amount of it can be stored in the memory, and only a limited amount of it can be displayed on the screen. It would be appropriate to store this in memory for one or more reason. That is, it is better to store the data that is available in the input and output in the memory. So memory is volatile and its content will be lost when the program is terminated. So memory is volatile in nature and its contents are removed or will be lost. So if we need the same data again, it would never be either entered through the keyboard again or would have to be regenerated programmatically. So both these operations would be tedious. So I have to key in all the data again and again, or I have to key the or get the regenerate the programs again and again. At such times, it's become necessary to store the data in a manner that can be later retrieved and displayed either in part or as whole. This medium is known as a usually a file on the disk. That is, every program I have to write, every code I have to write in the file that is stored in the disk, that is displayed on the or stored in the memory, that is disk. This chapter discusses how file input output operations can be performed. That is how we can get the input and how we can generate the output, that is input output operation, so is performed or can be performed. First is data organization. That is the first topic, that is data organization. So this says, before we start doing file input output, let us first find out how data is organized on the disk. That is, before we start doing the file input output operations, so let us first find out how data is organized on the disk. All data stored on the disk is in binary form. That is, whatever the data that is stored on the disk is in binary form. How this binary form is stored on the disk, that varies from OS to the OS. That is, it's a data organization, means how to organize the data, that depends on the memory to the memory. If this is a disk, that is a different concept. If that is a floppy, that is a different concept. So it depends on the memory to memory, how data will be organized on the disk. However, this does not affect the C programmer, since he has to use only the library function that is written for the particular OS to be able to perform input-output. It is the compiler vendor responsibility to correctly implement these library functions by taking the help of operating system. That is, it is the compiler or the it is the vendor's responsibility to correctly implement the library function that is taken or that is using the help of or that taking the help of the operating system. This is illustrated in the figure that is 12.1. That is illustrated. That is how data will be organized in the memory, in the disk. That is the R program. That is the first program. That is then there is a C library function. That is the main program. That is converted or that is divided into the C programming or library functions. That again is divided into next part. What is the next part? That is the operating system. Then there is a disk. So this is the provision how data will be stored in this. So first of all, program, then library functions, then operating system, then disk. Now, what is the file operations or what are the file operations? So till now we have discussed about how what is the need of the creating a file on the disk and how data will be organized, that is data organization. Now next part is file operations, means what are the operations that we performed on the file, that is the file operations. This says there are multiple or there are different operations that can be carried out on a file. What are the operations? We can create a new file. We can open an existing file, we can read from a file, we can write to a file, we can move to a specific location in a file, we can close the file. So these are the various elements, these are the various operations that is performing under the file. That is creating a new file, opening, reading, writing, moving, closing. Now let us write this or let us now write a program to read a file and display its content on the screen. We will first list the program and show what it is or it does and then deselect or dissect it line by line. Here is the listing. Means what is the listing, how it will be available, what are the operations that will be performed under the file, that is the file operations. So this is a program that is used to display contents of a file on the screen. That is, this is the best example, this is the first example that shows how to display the contents of a file on the screen. Now, first of all, there is a hash include stdio.h. That is, we can include the file, we can include the first file, we can include the header file, that is standard input output. Means there is some standard input output that is given under this. Then uses the main function, that is the void main function. Means if there is no against or before this one, prior to main, so this is the void, that is means there is no return type, that is a void main. Then for file, we are using the file in a capital letter, that is a file, file. This is the pointer variable that is used for the file, that is pointer fp. So this is the file that is in capital letter, that is we are generating a file pointer. What is the name of the pointer? That is fp, that is pointer fp. Then char ch, so ch is also a variable that is of character type. So file is a keyword that is used for the file, fp is a pointer that is used for this, ch is a variable that is of type char. Now uses the fp equals to fopen. This is a function that is used to open the file. Till now we have declared one file variable, that is fp, and one character variable, that is ch. Then my task is to open the file by using the fopen function and then print the output or whatever we return in the open function, fopen function, that will be stored in the fp. So this is fopen, then pr1.c, that is pr1.c is the name of the file that is only in read mode. So I'm using in double quotes, that is pr1.c. So pr1.c is the name of the file. And this is the read operation, that is the R. This will be enclosed in the double quotes. So pr1.c and there is a read operation. That uses the while, that is the while loop is used and there is a one. That is, it will terminate only when the one is encountered. Then there is a curly braces then ch equals to f get c fp. That is using the this f get c function, and then uses the file pointer that is fp, that will be or that will display the output, or the output of this f get c is stored in the ch variable. Now check the ch with the end of the file. This is the end of the file. If ch equal equals to end of the file, that if the variable that is the ch reaches to the end of the file, then there is a break statement, then printf percentage c, then print the value ch. Then there is a curly brace close for this while loop, and then after this there is a f close for closing the file pointer, that is a f close. There is a closing of the curly brace, that is closing of the next part, that is a ending of the curly brace, that is of main function. So this is a loop, or this is the program that shows how file operations will be performed, how we can display the file operations. So I'm repeating again, first of all the header file will be included, then there is a main function, then there is a curly brace, there is a file, that is a keyword, one file pointer will be declared, that is of fp, then one character or the one ch variable is declared, that is of character type, then we open the file first of all, that is by f open, then pr1.c, so this is the name of the file that is in read operations. So pr1.c is the file name that is only in the read mode. So these are the various operations, these are the various access modes that is available. One is read, one is write, one is execute. This is available only in the read operation, that is r. Then uses the while loop, that is the while condition. So it will terminate till 1, then uses the variable as a ch, and then stored the output of the fgetc function. That is fgetc function is used with the file pointer, that is the fp. Then uses or the if loop, that is if ch is equals to the end of the file. That is if the fgetc function reaches to the end of the file, then there is a break statement. Then printf, that is printing the value of the ch. So this is the while loop that will starting with this curly brace and ending with closing curly brace. So this is the syntax for the while loop, and there is then the file will be closed by using the fclose function. Then there is a curly brace close for the main function. Now let's see what we have covered in this one. This says on execution of this program, it display the content of the file, that is pr1.c. So pr1.c is the name of the file. So when we execute this program, it will display the content, every content that is stored in the pr1.c on the screen. Now let us understand how it will open, how it will close, how it will display, and how it will close the file. So first of all, opening a file, that is the first target, that is how to open the file. This says before we can read or write information from to or a file on a disk, we must open a file. That is the main task. That is first of all we have to open the file, that is opening a file. So the first part is opening a file, that is how to open the file. So before we can write, before we can read any information from the file, we must open the file. That is the first condition. That is first of all, the file will be opened, then only we can either write, we can either read the data from the disk. To open the file, we have called the function that is known as the fopen. So fopen is used to open the file. It would open a file, that is pr1.c, in read mode. As I told you, it is opened, or it will be opened in the read mode because I am using the r. Which tells the C compiler that we will be or we would be reading the contents of the file. Note that R is a string, not a character. That is till now we have covered that only single character is a character. No, in this R is a string, hence the double quotes and not single quotes. That is, if it is a single character, that I have to use the single quotes, but if it is in double quotes, that means it is a string. In fact, fopen performs three important tasks. What are the three important tasks that is available for the fopen? That is, what are the three important roles of the fopen? The first of all, it searches on the disk the file to be opened. That is, fopen function search, searches for the file that is available on the disk that I want to be opened. Then it loads the file from the disk to a place in the memory known as buffer. That is, first of all, it searches the file, then it loads the file from the disk into the place or into a place in memory that is known as the buffer. The buffer is a place in the memory that is used to load from the file into the, or from the disk into a place that is known as the buffer. Then it sets up a character pointer that points to the first character of the buffer. That is, first of all, or it set up a character pointer. Then it set up character pointer that is a FP pointer that points to the first character of the buffer. So first of all, it searches for the file, then loads the file from the disk to the memory. Then at the third point, it set a character pointer for the file, that is a file FP. Now, why do we need a buffer at all? Imagine how insufficient it would be to actually access that disk every time we need to read a character from it. Every time we read something from a disk, it takes some time for the disk drive to position the read write head correctly. On a floppy disk, the drive motor had to actually rotating the disk every time. This is a story of the how the file will be stored in the disk, how the floppy disk writes the data on the file, and so on, so on, so on. So this is not in your matter that how the data will be written by using the floppy disk. This is where a buffer comes in. That is, this is the where a buffer comes in, that is, we can store the data into the buffer. It could be more sensible to read the contents of the file into the buffer while opening the file and then read the file character by character from the buffer rather than from the disk. That is, we have enclosed or we have to take the data from the disk, or we have to take the file from the disk and store in the buffer so that we can take the character by character, that is character to character, from the buffer. Because it is possible to take the character by character from the buffer instead of the disk, because that is not possible in case of the disk, that we have to choose the buffer character by character from the disk. So it is advisable to first of all get the data. It is not advisable, but it is the role of the opening of file f of one function. It takes the data from the disk and put into the buffer. That is shown in the figure 12.2. This is the 12.2. This is PR1.C. That is a file. This is the memory. This is the buffer. So it puts the data from the disk. This is the disk, and put it in the buffer. This 40 will be put it, and this will be using the FP. That is, the file pointer is using the or FP is a pointer variable that stores the address. So this is the address for the buffer, that is 40, that will be stored by the FP. So FP is a pointer variable that stores the value, or the state stores the address as a 40. Same argument also applies to writing the information in a file. In till now we have covered how to read the file, how to get the file, how to open the file. Now the same argument, the same concept is also applies to the writing the information in a file. Instead of writing characters in the file on a disk, one character at a time, it would be more efficient to write characters in a buffer and then finally transfer the content from the buffer to the disk. That is, it is advisable, or it would be more efficient to write the characters in a buffer and then finally transfer the content from the buffer to the disk. To be able to successfully read from a file information like mode of opening, size of file, place in the file from where the next read of operation will be performed, etc. has to be maintained. So whenever we have to take the information, read the file, the following information will be used, like how to open, what is the mode of opening, size of file, place in the file, from where the next read operation would be performed, etc. has to be maintained. Since all this information is interrelated, all of it is gathered together by the fopen in a structure that is known as the file.fopen. That is, we are using the fopen function in a structure that opens the file, that is also known as the file.fopen function, that returns the address of this structure which we have collected in the structure pointer that is known as the FP. So we have collected the, or we have declared one pointer variable that is FP, that is used to return the address, that is used to collect the address, that is a FP pointer. So FP is a pointer that is a file type that stores the output that takes the structure pointer. The file structure like this one, the file structure have been defined in the header file, that is stdio.h. So this file will be stored in the header file. What is the name of the header file? That is stdio.h, that is standing for standard input output header file. Therefore it is necessary to hash include this file, that is it is mandatory to use the hash include in the file operation or the in the file input output programs, because the file keyword or the file function, that is the keyword that is stored in the stdio.h, that is a header file, that is hash include stdio.h. Then reading from a file, first of all how to open a file. Now next part is how to read from a file. How to open? By using the fopen function. Then how to read? By using the fopen and then using the pointer variable, also using the fgetch function. This says once the paragraph once the file has been opened for reading using fopen function. That is once the file has been opened for reading using the fopen function. So one function is used, that is fopen function, that is used for the reading. As we have seen, the file's content are brought into the buffer partly or wholly. That is, we can either put the content partly or either we can put the content wholly, and a pointer is set up that points to the first character in the buffer. This pointer is one of the element of the structure to which FP is pointing. That is, FP is a pointer variable that is used as an element of the structure to which FP is pointing. To read the file content from the memory, there exists a function known as the fgetc function. So in simple terms, whenever we have to read the data from the file, we use the fgetc function. And whenever we have to open a file, we use fopen function. That is discussed or that is used in the program, that is this one, that is fgetc fp. Then that output of fgetc fp is stored in the ch function. This fgetc reads the character from the current pointer position. That is, fgetc reads the data or takes the data from the current pointer position. Suppose the current pointer position is at the 3034. So it reads the data from the current pointer position, then advances the pointer position so that it now points to the next character. That is, it moves to the character or it approaches to the next character step by step, and then return the character that is read, which we have collected in the variable ch. That is, it reads the character, advances the character, that is moves the character one position to another, so that it can now point to the next character and then return the character that is read, which we have collected in the variable that is ch. Note that when the file has been opened, we no longer refer to the file by its name, but we use the pointer variable, file pointer, that is known as the FP. That is, the main task of using the FP is to use the or is to only open the file. There is no longer way to use the file by its name. We have to use the pointer variable, we have to use the file pointer, that is FP. We have used the function fgetc within an indefinite while loop. This is the main program. We have used the fgetc function in the this one, that is in the while loop. There has to be way to break out of this file. When shall we break out? The moment we reach to the end of the file. We also use this if ch equals to end of the file. That is, there is a break statement that denotes how to reach at the end of the file. But what is the end of the file? A special character whose ASCII value is 26 signifies end of the file. That is the ASCII value, that is the special character. If the ASCII value reaches to the 26, that means there is the end of the file which we have created. While reading from a file, When fgetseek encounters this special character, instead of returning the character that is at red, it returns the macro end of the file. So we are using the end of the file macro, that is EOF macro, that is defined in the stdio.h. This is the header file that is used, that also includes the EOF function, EOF macro. So one macro that is using the file, that is file in capital, then EOF, that is end of the file macro, that is also defined in the stdio.h. In place of the function fgetc, we have used the macro getc with the same effect. That is, we can also use the fgetc in getc in place of the fgetc. Both give the same effect. In our program, we go on reading each character. We go on reading each character from a file till the end of file is not met. That is, if ch equal equals to end of file, that means we have to go through the character by character till we have not met the end of the file. As soon as we met the end of the file, the loop will terminate. We have to go beyond the loop. Next point says, as each character is read, we display it on the screen. Once out of the loop, we close the file. Now, what is the trouble in opening a file? There is a possibility. Try to open a file using the function fopen. The file may not be open. That is, there is this is also a condition. That is, if my requirement is to open a file using the pointer using the function fopen, the file may not be open. While opening a file in R mode, this may happen because the file being opened may not be present on the disk at all. That is, if I have to use the R, that is a read mode operation, that is the R operation, read operation. This is also possible that the file is not available on the disk and you obviously cannot read a file that does not exist. So this is so obvious. If there is a no file, if there is a file that does not exist, you cannot read the data from the file. Similarly, while opening the file for writing, fopen may fail due to n number of reasons, like disk space may be insufficient, or disk may be write protected, or the disk is damaged. There are varied conditions that is used, that is, we are not using the, or we are not able to cope up, we are not able to open the file. That reason may be any reason. Either the disk space is insufficient, either the disk may be write protected, either the disk is damaged, or so on. There are so many conditions. The crux of the matter is that it is important for any program that accesses the file to check whether the file has been opened successfully before trying to read or write to the file. That is, there is no motto to simply use the read-write operations until and unless you don't know that it is suitable to open the file. You cannot try to read or write the file, or read or write from the file, because this is a time wastage. If the file does not exist, how can you read or write the operations? How can you read or write into the file? If the file opens fail due to n number of reasons, the fopen returns a null character that is also defined in stdio.h as this one. Here is how this can be handled in a program. That is, hash include stdio.h. Then there is a main function. Then there is the same file file. Then there is a pointer variable, that is fp. Then fp equals to fopen, this one, the same concept. Now check for the fp first of all. If the fp equal equals to null, that is, if the fp contains nothing, that is equals to zero, that is, there is no content in the fp, then puts, that is display, the content cannot open the file, and then there is a exit function. So this is, if fp equal equals to null, that is, if the fp contains nothing, that is equals to the zero, then puts, that uses the puts operation, uses the puts function, that cannot open a file. Then there is a exit condition. Then curly braces will be closed, and then main curly braces will be closed. So in simple terms, this program reflects how we can check for the file before trying to read or write from the file. That is how we can check in the file. How we can check? By using the if condition. What is the if condition? That is, if fp equal equals to null, that is, if it equals to null, that it reaches to the zero, then printf, that it cannot read the, or it cannot open the file. Otherwise, it can open the file. Then there is a exit condition. So this is the scenario how it will be used. So in simple terms, the crux is that before trying to read or write the data from the file, first of all check if the file exists or not. This is the curly brace open and the close for the if, and this is the close for the main, open for the main. Now next is closing the file. This is I will discuss after the break. So first of all take the break and then come back starting with this topic, that is how to close the file. You believe me, this is very interesting topic in C language because everything is rotating on the file. So let's take a break for 5 to 10 minutes and come back. Next topic is closing the file, that is how to close the file. Till now we have discussed how to open the file and how to read the file. Now next part is how to close the file. So this is the concept of opening a file. That function is used, which is the function, that is the fopen function is used to open the file. In the same way, how to read the file, that is the function that is used is fgetc function. This is the program that is written over here. Then what are the troubles in opening a file? The main trouble is that if there is a null, that is the file contains nothing, then how we can print the output? This is the program that shows how to check the file for the null characters. Now the next concept is how to close the file, that is closing the file. The function that is used for closing the file is fclose function. So till now we have finished reading from the file, now we need to close it. That is, till now we have covered how to open and how to read the data. The next part is how to close the file, that is done by using the function, that is the fclose function. This is the statement that is used to close the file. The same pointer is used, that is the file pointer, fp pointer, that stores the address of the file variable, that stores the address of the file pointer. So now the file will be closed by using the same pointer. That means every operation is performed by using the same pointer variable, that is the fp pointer variable. Now it is the time to close the file by using the fclose function. So this is the argument that is given within the parenthesis, within the brackets, that is the fclose fp. So once we close the file, we can no longer read it from using the getc function. That is, this is the function that is used to close the file. So once we close the file, there is no way to get the function. There is no way to get or read the file by using the getc, unless and until we reopen the file. So first of all, we have to reopen the file, then only we can read the data from the file. Note that to close the file, we don't need to use the file name, but the file pointer fp. On closing a file, everything that is associated with the file, whether the content, whether the pointer, that will be closed or that will be removed from the memory. So the operations, one is opening a file, that means we get the space in the memory, or the C program get the space in the memory, then read the data, and then after closing the file, this or that space that is available in the memory will get removed from the memory. So in this program we have opened the file for reading. Suppose we open a file with an intention to write the characters, that is my motto is to write the characters, write the array of character that is string into the file. This time to a buffer would get associated with it. When we attempt to write the characters into a file, that is when my task is to write the characters into a file using the fputc functions, the characters get written into the buffer. So now new function will be added. One is getc, that is fgetc for reading the file. One is fputc for writing the for writing the characters into the buffer. When we close the file, the three operations will be performed. What are the three operations? First of all, the memory will be vacant, that is the file will be eliminated from the memory. The next point is the characters in the buffer would be written to the file on the disk. At the end of the file, a character with ASCII value 26 would get written. That is, When we close the file, these are the three operations that will be performed. For the first operation is that the characters in the buffer would be written into the file on the disk. Then the buffer will be eliminated or will be deleted from the memory. Then at the end of the file, the ASCII value would get written. That is at the end of the string. You can imagine a possibility when the buffer may become full before we close the file. That is, there is also a possibility the buffer is full and we want to close the file. In such a case, the buffer contents would be returned to the disk the moment it becomes full. All this buffer management is done for us by using the library function. So this is the use of the library functions only. What are the library functions? Fopen, fclose, fgetc, fputc. So these are the basic operations that will be that is to be done on the file that is available in C. Now, next is how to count the characters, how to count the tabs, how to count the space, or how to count the special symbols that is available in any C program. Suppose I have written a C program that contains the four space, and I have to count the spaces, tabs, symbols. There is also a provision, there is also a function that is available to count the characters, count the tabs, count the spaces. Now let's discuss the function that counts the characters, tabs, spaces. This is the program that is used to count the characters. First of all, it approaches to the end of the file. That is, if the variable approaches to the end of the file, then there is a break. Otherwise, if there is a space, that will be denoted by empty single quotes. If there is a next line, that will be enclosed within a single line, that is a slash n. There is a slash t, means there is a tab. So slash n is used for the next line, single or the empty single quote is used for the gap, and the t, that is slash t, is used for the tab. So there are three methods, or there are three ways how we can calculate, or how we can check the space, how we can check the next line, how we can check the tab. Remember, slash t and the slash n are the escape sequence character that is used with the printf statement in C language. So first of all, the same include stdio.h, that is the same concept, that is the header file will be included, that is the standard input output.h. Then there is a main function, that is a void main function, that is the main entry of the program. Then there is a file keyword, that is file in capital letters. Then there is a pointer variable of the, or the file pointer, that is known as the pointer fp. Then we have declared, or I have declared one character pointer, or one character variable, that is ch, and that is of character type. So this means it can store only one byte of memory, or it reserves only one byte of memory in the one byte of memory, because char takes only one byte, while int takes two bytes. Next, in the next line, it is defining, that is nol equals to 0, not equals to 0, nob, noc. These four variables are aligning, or are allotting the values as a 0, assigning the values as a 0, and they take the memory space as a 2 bytes. That is, NOL takes 2 bytes in memory, NOT takes 2 bytes in memory, NOB takes 2 bytes in memory, as well as NOC takes 2 bytes in memory. Then uses the next function, uses the file pointer to open the file. Which function is used? That is a fopen function. Now, which file will be opened? That is pr1.c. So this is the file that will be opened, that is pr1.c, for the read operation. How do I know it is only for read operation or write operation? This r denotes it is used for the read operation. Then uses the while one, that is uses the while condition. Then uses ch equals to fgetc. That means we can read the data by using the file pointer and stores the output in the ch. Now, check the condition, whether the file is empty or not. How to check the condition? By using the if, that is if ch equal equals to end of file. That is, if ch equals to end of the file, then there is a break statement. Then increment the NOC plus plus every time. Now, check for the single space, that is there is no character, there is a space, then NOB plus plus. Then if NO, ch equals to slash n, then NOL plus plus, then if CH equals to T, that is if there is a tap, then NOT plus plus plus. That is, it will increment, that is also equals to the NOT equals to NOT plus 1. Then there is the ending of the curly brace. That is, this is the ending of the while loop. Then uses the fclose function for the file pointers. Then it uses the fclose function for closing the file pointer, that is the fclose fp. Now these are the printf statement that displays the number of characters, number of blank spaces, number of tabs, number of lines that is used in this program. How compiler or how C program calculates the number of characters, number of spaces, number of blank spaces, number of tabs, number of lines? By using the if condition and the increment condition, that is NOB plus plus, NOC plus plus, NON plus plus, NOT plus plus. So this every time it will execute, every time it will increment till the loop is never terminate or till the loop terminates. So this is, these are the various printf statements. Now the output is this one. The number of characters is 125, means there are total 125 characters that includes everything. And there are a number of blank spaces, that is 25, number of tabs, that is 13, number of lines, that is 22. The above program are true for a file p1.c which I had on my disk. You can give another file name and obtain a different result. That is, you can get any file name, you can take any input for the file and get the different result. In this program, we have opened the file for reading and read it by character by character. Now, let us try a program that read to open or that needs to open a file for writing. So, till now we have covered how to read the file, how to open the file. Now, the next part says how to write the file into the, or how to write the content into the file, or how to open a file for the writing. So, that is the file copy program. So which function is used for reading the data, that is fgetc, and which function is used to writing the data, that is fputc. So we have already used this function, that is the fgetc, which reads the character from a file, and its counterpart, that is the next part, that is using the fputc, that writes the character to the file. So the same concept, the fgetc is used to write the fgetc is used to read the data or read the characters from the file, while the fputc is to write the data into the file. As the name advises, getc means getting something, that is read the data. One is fputc, that is putting, means inserting something, that is write the data into the file. As a practical approach, we can use the input output function. We can take the data from one file, we can put the data into the another file. That is, fgetc is used to take the data from another file or for a different file, and putc is used to insert the data into the another file. This program takes the content of the file and copies them into the another file character by character. This program shows how to get the data from one file and how to read the data into the another file. This is hash include stdio.h. That is the main starting phase, that is a header file. Can anyone tell me what is the full form of stdio.h? With the use of chat or with the use of headphone, can anyone tell me what is the full form of stdio.h in this program? My question is to all of you, Larry. Okay. Yeah, Larry. Good. Standard. Yeah, it means standard input output dot h, right? And what is the full form of ASCII? That is ASCII. Can anyone tell me what is the full form of ASCII? Either you can use the chat, either you can use the headphones. Yeah, I want the answer from you that what is the full form of ASCII? That is ASCII. Yeah. American Standard Code for Information Interchange. I'm repeating again. American Standard Code for Information Interchange. Right. Now, there is a stdio.h, then there is a main function. Then there is a file keyword. There are two pointers are used. One is fs, one is ft. So there here, two pointers are used. One is only fs, one is only ft. That is a file pointers. Then one character will be declared, one character variable, that is ch variable, or ch variable that is of character type. Then again uses the fs and stores the data for opening a file. That is fopen is used to open the file. In this we are opening a file that is fpr1.c. The same example, that is pr1.c is the name of the file that will be enclosed in a double quotes. Then there is a comma, then there is a, it is only used for the read operation. That's why we are using r. If it is used for the write operation, then I will use w in the next part, in the next block of code. Now check for the null, that is whether I open the file, it may be null, that is it, there is no content in the file. Then what is the motto of reading or writing the data into the file? There is no motto. If there is no, or there is nothing in the file. So first of all, check for the null character. That is first of all, check whether there is data or whether there is anything that is available in the file or not. So check the condition by using the, or by using the if condition. If fs equal equals to null. Why I'm using the double equals to or equal equals to? Because it is used for calculating the comparison. It is used for checking the condition. If I'm using single equals to, that is only one equals to, that means we are aligning or we are assigning the values. So there is a difference. One is assignment operator, one is comparison operator. Assignment means whenever we use the single equals to, that means there is a assignment operator. And whenever we use the double equals to, that means there is a comparison operator. So if I'm using, if fs equal equals to null, that is checking the condition, then puts cannot open the source file. That is, if it is equals to null, that means there is no content, so we cannot open the source file. Then there is a exit function, that means exit from the program. Then curly braces will be closed. So this is the code for the opening of file. Now it's a time to write the data into the file, that is write anything into the file. Now again, next file pointer is used, that is ft. Again we are opening a file. There is another file, that is pr2.c. now let's see the difference. Now the difference is that whenever we open the file for reading, we use the r. Whenever we use the file for writing, we use the w, that is w-r-i-t-e, write. Whenever we use the file for reading, that is a r. Whenever we use the file for writing, we use the w. It's the same concept, only the file name will be different and the mode will be different. Now it is w. If ft equal equals to null, that is again checking the condition, that is if the file contains nothing, that is equal equals to the null, then puts, what is puts, that is printf, cannot open the target file. That is, we cannot open the target files. Then uses the fp. If there is nothing, so we cannot write anything into the file. So fclose will be used to close the files, that is fs. Now there is an exit condition. This is the if part. Now check the while one, that is the while condition will be used, that uses ch equals to fgetc fs. Now fgetc is used for reading the file that will be enclosed, or that will be stored in the ch function or ch variable. Now check the condition. If ch equal equals to end of file, so check the condition. If it is reaches to the end of the file, then there is a break, otherwise put c, This is the condition, main condition. Otherwise, put C, FT into the CH. Whatever you find in the FT, that is whatever the data you find in the FT, that is put into the CH variable. Now, fclose is used for closing the FS. Again, fclose is used for closing the FT. So these are the various conditions, these are the various codes that is written over here. So one is used for the opening, one is used for the reading, one is used for the writing. So means first of all check the condition, is if it is equals to null, that means we cannot read the data or we cannot open the file. If there is that is equals to null, we cannot access the data. Now fclose is used for closing the file. I hope most of the stuff in the program can be understood since it has already been dealt with the earlier section. What is new is the fputc function. Fputc function means fputc function means putting the file or writing the data into the file. That is the fputc function. Next is how to write writing into a file or writing to a file. So which function is used for writing for a file into a file? That is the fputc function is used for writing into a file. That is similar to the or this function, that is the fputc function is similar to the putch function in the sense both are the output characters. That is both output characters. That is both is used or both functions are used for displaying the output on the screen. However, putc function always writes to the video, whereas fputc function writes to the file. So in the last chapter we have discussed how to use the putc function, that is used to display the characters or display the output on the video, that is the video display unit, while the fputc writes the data into the file. That is the main difference. Which file? That is file signified by the pointer, file pointer, that is FT. The writing process continues till all the characters from the source file has been written to the target file. That is the we have to write the file, the whole writing process continues or goes on till all the characters from the source file has been written into the target file. That is all the files have been written or all the files have been modified from the source to the target file. Source means from where we have to fetch the data, target means from into which we have to keep the data, following which the while loop terminates. Note that our simple or sample file copy program is capable of copying only text files. To copy the file with extension .exe or .com, we need to open the file in binary mode. That is topic that is dealt in the later section. Now, what are the file opening modes? This is one of the important topic. So next topic is file opening modes. That is what are the modes that is available for opening a file. As I told you, there are multiple ways to open the file. One of the ways open the file is using the R mode, then W mode. So the task that is performed by the F open when a file is opened in each of these modes are also mentioned. That is whenever we use the F open function that is used to open the file. So we can open the file in any of the mode, in any of the mode that is given in or that is mentioned in over here. So one is R, that is searches for a file. That is if the file is opened successfully, then it's loaded into the memory and set up a pointer which points to the first character in it. If the file cannot be opened, the fopen returns the null. So that is the read-only. That is the read-only mode. that if it is encountered or it is the file is successfully opened or opened successfully, then fopen loads into the memory and set up a pointer that points to the first character in it. If the file cannot open, fopen then returns the null. Operations possible, that is reading from the file. Next is w, that is searches a file, that is search for a file, that is the next operation that is used for writing the file. If the file exists, its contents are overwritten. If it does not, a new file is created. Creates null if unable to open a file. Operation possible, writing to the file. Next a, that is searches the file. If the file opened successfully, it loads into the memory and set a pointer to the last character, that is sets the pointer to the last character. If the file does not exist, a new file is created and then returns the null if it is unable to open the file. What is the operation? That adding the content to the end of the file. So these are the three. One is R, reading purpose, writing purpose. Appending means adding the content to the end of the file. Then R plus, it also used for searching a file or searching a file. If the operation is done or it is opened successfully, fopen loads into the memory and set a pointer which points to the first character in it. Returns the null if unable to open the file. So these are the various conditions, these are the various scenarios whenever we use the fopen, fclose. So R++, what is the operation? Reading the existing content, writing the new content, modifying the existing content. So with the use of R+, we can either read the existing content, we can either write the new content, or we can either modify the existing content. Then W+, that is overwritten, as a new file, unable to open the file. What are the operations? Writing the new content, reading them back, and modify the existing content. That is the same, means whenever we use the R+, W+, in simple R, that means reading. In R+, reading the existing file, create a new file, modifying the existing file. In the same way, W+, writing a new file, writing the existing file, or modify the existing content of the file. Next is A+, that A means appending a file, that is adding the content to the end of the file. In the same way, whenever there is a A+, that is reading the existing content, appending a new content to the end of the file, cannot modify the existing content. So these are the various file operations that you need to take a note of it, of the all the file operations. The basic are the only three operations, that is R, W, A. Then R plus, W plus is not in so much of use, but these three are the very important, that is R, W and A. R means reading, W means writing, A means appending, that is adding the value at the end of the file. Right. So next topic is string output in files. That is the next topic that I have to cover in the next chapter, in the next class, that is in tomorrow's class. So let's stop over here only. So if you have any doubts, then please text the doubt and I will answer you. In the tomorrow's class, I will be discussing the next chapter, that is the input output in files, that is how to take the input output in files. So let's stop over here only. So thanks a lot everyone for listening me. Now if you have any doubts, then please clear the doubt and I will answer you. So thanks a lot everyone. Bye bye.